What's up, YouTube? My name is Alex. I'm a level 2 tech support specialist for Rane DJ, and we've been getting quite a few inquiries lately on the aero lights on the Rane 12. Some people have been saying these don't work properly. Some people are asking how these work, and I'm gonna do a real quick video right now to explain exactly what to be looking for and when these should be lighting up. The great thing about the Rane 12 is you can use one of these decks to control up to 4 decks in Serato DJ Pro. So right now I've got my left deck set up for decks 1 and 2. So you can see if I move the platter, controlling deck 1. If I press the deck 2 button on the 12, now I'm controlling deck 2. Now when you're using 112 to control multiple decks in Serato, you'll need to make adjustments with your pitch fader a little bit differently than you would if you had 2 separate units. So if I'm on deck 2 and I make an adjustment to the BPM, let's increase this a little bit to 103.3. Okay, now I'm gonna switch back to deck 1 and you'll see that this arrow has lit up. This is letting me know that I need to move the pitch fader back in the left direction before I can make any adjustments to the pitch on the left deck. So now that I've moved it back to the center where it was located previously, I can now move the fader to the right to increase my BPM, or I can move it to the left of the 0 point to decrease my BPM. Okay, so we'll leave it right here at 95.4, then we're going to switch back to deck 2, and now it's instructing us to move the pitch fader to the right. Okay, still have to keep going because that arrow is still lit. Now it's back to the point where it was when we were previously on this deck. So now I can make those adjustments to the BPM again. Same thing. If I switch back to deck 1, it's going to tell me that I need to bring the fader this way to be able to make adjustments again. Move it back. And now my BPMs are able to be adjusted again. So that's how you use the arrows on the Rane 12s.